So recording has begun. So we will now discuss the assembly for a Clapper block. So the first step, as we always remember, setting the project file. So if you see currently the tool post is highlighted, which means the current project file is tool post. So but we will change it to Clapper block. So let me browse where it is. And Clapper block, I have the Clapper block project file. I click on it, and now you see current. Now the Clapper block project file is being selected and tick mark, which shows it is the current project file. And I, since it is done, I click on done. And just as a confirmation, yes, you see here also Clapper block is selected. So we are going to assembly, file, new, and from here in metric assembly में standard mm dot iam, I click on create. I click on OK. So now I need to call components. So please remember, sometimes, you know, by default here in this place command, some of your place might be highlighted, some of your place from content center or some other options will be highlighted. Please remember, by default should be place. That is, we need to select this place file. But the other thing are, you know, there's many of the standard components like nuts and screws and all are already available in the library. So the other options are for directly selecting it from there, which we are not going to use now. We are just going to use a simple place command. So since it's there, so now Clapper block is the project file. So the components which are present in the Clapper block are shown over here. Now sometimes, you know, you might not be able to identify the component when you are in a hurry, like what is a clamping screw, how does this appear. So to that, you can just change the view from here. You can increase the size to maybe say medium items, and when you have changed the size, you can now actually visualize how the component also appears, and accordingly you can take a decision on which component is to be called. So let us call this drag and release component first, because many components are first assembled to the drag and pre-release component, and then we will hold it to the civil plate. So I'll call the drag and plate. I click okay. So I didn't click, I just escape. Then drag and release, open. Let me click it and paste the instance, and I don't want the second instance, so I click on escape now. I will bring the front view. So wait, I will change the orientation and I will set this as my front view. And now I will just slightly rotate it. Okay. Now into this, we will assemble various components. See, currently I haven't grounded anything. I have just kept it free, which means I can move, I can span, I can rotate this component. I will assemble some components, and then we will use the ground command. So let me call the second component which goes in. The second component, please remember, is the tool holder. I am calling the tool holder. I am just placing somewhere to fix the instance, and then escaping command to end the command. Now I need to assemble this component into the swivel drag and play. So how do we do that? First of all, I will just slightly rotate the screw. So I will use the free rotate command. Please remember, if I use this rotate command, then the complete, that is, I use the free orbit command, then the complete drawing will rotate, and that is, all two components will revolve. So I will just use the free rotate command, so that only the selected component rotates like this. So this is how the assembly is to be done, wherein the axis of this body, or axis, what do we call this component as? So to check that, I will just go back to the place component, and from the place component, so we are calling this component as tool holder, the other component is drag and release plate. So the tool holder, the axis of this tool holder should be aligned with the axis of this hole, such that the inner face of this base should match the should mate with the inner face of this drag and release plate. So first constraint, I will align the axes. So I will select this surface so that the axis of the surface is selected, and I will select this surface so that the corresponding axis is selected. They have aligned. I click on apply, and now you can see it is constrained to move along this axis only. It can move inwards and outwards, and it can rotate about this axis. That is the only motion that is possible. Now this plate is also moving up and down. You see that is, this drag and release plate is also moving up and down, because we haven't yet fixed the drag and release plate. Now second command, I will select this face from here. Now I will slightly rotate this object, And from here, let me select this object and I click on apply. Now, if you see, these two faces are in contact. So these two faces will move together. Only they can have this rotation in between them. Now to fix this also, what should I use? I can use the angle command. So this angle command, directed angle, and then I will specify that between this flat surface and between this flat surface, make the angle always zero in this case. So I click on apply. Now these two have been assembled. Now I will call the plate. So go to place, place mein, I will call the single plate, open. I will click somewhere just to place an instance and then click on escape to end the command. Now we need to assemble these two together. So what, remember what you need to understand is this swivel plate, has a smooth radius over here. So this is the face of the swivel plate. It is going to be in touch with this particular face. So I will slightly rotate the swivel plate. Okay, I will just reduce the size now and what I will say is constrain this face and this. Next constraint that I need to do is I need to align these whole centers. So click on the align center and I click on this axis and I also click on, I am not able to select that axis, so I will click on cancel. I will slightly move this away and now we have to select the constraint axis. Constraint my first, I will select, me select this axis. Yeah, the axis is now selected and I will select the axis of these holes also. Yes, yeah, now the axis selected and I click on apply. What has happened? It seems like we have already applied the constraint. Just let me check. I will try once again using the constraint command. This axis and this axis. I will just delete some of the constraints first. Now let me check, align this axis. Aha, okay. Wait, the mistake that we just did is, let me first delete this. Now I will just constrain this axis and this axis. I will rotate the figure slightly. Okay. Now, in general, the assembly of the tool holder is such that why we have given this radius? That is because I will fix this grounded. Okay. So this is actually a shaper machine where you have used in tool. So, वहाँ पे we grounded the wrong component. So this is the motion that we will be giving. That is, it is free to swivel up and down. But since it is also swiveling along this direction, we will fix this. So for that, we will constrain the sides. Using the constraint command, I will select this face, and I will select the other face with which it is to be in touch. So that face is selected, and I click on apply. Now I will just slightly reorient the figure and rotate it slightly. Okay. Now this is the motion in general that is given. Matlab, you cannot allow it here since material is at one grab back. While returning back, it will be having this swirling motion like this that you see. In general, application practice. But now for the current practice, we'll fix this also. That for fixing that, we will use the angle command later on after we finish the assembly. So first, now this, if you remember, while doing this, accidentally we had deleted the angle constraint which we had given between the tool holder and the drag and release plate. So that is why this, you see, this is rotating. So this tool holder is rotating with respect to the drag and release plate. So let us fix that first. So I will select constraint command, and I will select one flat surface. Let me select the angle command, directed angle, selecting the first surface, and the second surface is the surface, but since we can't select it, I will slightly just pull it a little bit out. Now let me use the constraint command once again, going to angle, directed angle. From here, I will select this surface, and I will select, my surface is not selected rightly, so I will just slightly rotate it. And now from here, I will select the face, and the angle is 0, and I click on apply. Okay. Now next component that is to be called will be the washer. I will click on open. Now washer is a plane component. This washer, the both surfaces are flat. So I will just select constraint command. I will first align the axis of the tool holder with the axis of the washer, then I click on apply. Now I will slide, now I will constrain, or I will align this face of the drag and release plate with this face of the inner face of the washer. So selecting the right face, and I click on apply, and we have constrained them. The last component which has to be placed is the screw. So calling the screw once again from the folder, the clamping screw, I am placing it to create an instance, escape to enter command. Now I will slightly rotate this and align it as required. So using the free rotate command, I will select the component, and I will just change the orientation because this has to be inserted in this particular fashion. Now I'll end the command by clicking escape. Selecting the constraint command, I will first constrain the axis of this tool holder with the axis of the clamping screw. Then I click on apply. Then now I will just show you, I will just rotate this view by a few degrees. Okay. Now what has happened is this screw is now constrained to move along the axis of the tool holder. But now we want to keep the screw in contact with the tool holder. So I will need to create a mating constraint between the relevant faces. So I will select that face. So since the figure is small, let me first zoom it so that becomes easier for me to select the constraint. From here, now I will say select constraint and keep this surface of the tool holder in contact. Let me just slightly rotate this. Yeah. Now this surface, if you remember, this is not actually a flat surface, so you cannot be able to select it. But however, you can select this edge. So I will just touch that edge so that that edge will be in contact with that surface, and I click on apply, and I finish this constraint command. I will reduce the size of the assembly slightly. Let me rotate it. Now with respect to this tool, respect to the tool holder, the screw is constrained. It cannot move along. It cannot move in any direction. It can now only rotate. So to prevent this rotation of the screw holder, the first option is I will specify the angle. So sorry, I will select the face of the clamping screw, and I will select one flat face of the tool holder. Sorry, I didn't select the angle command, directed angle. From here, yeah. Okay, now it's proper. The angle is also done. Apply. Now the only motion that is possible in this assembly is this motion that you see. between the tool holder and the swivel plate. We will also fix this motion for the tool holder. So to do that, what we can say is use the constraint command, and then I will say constrain this face and this face so that they are not possible by the check. Let us check if there is any error in the drawing. So I will just take it to the right view. Now if you look closely, when the view is right, when here we have said right view, but from here it is very clear to us that this figure is not exactly the right view, because we can actually have a 3D, slight 3D view. So that is, we will have to create an additional constraint, because we will have to fix the angle between the origin planes. So what I will do is, now between the plane XY and between one surface, I will just fix the angle in between them. I'll give an angle constraint. See, I will use the constraint angle. Constraint may say I will use the angle constraint directed. I will have, the plane is already selected. I will select the second surface. To select the second surface, I will slightly rotate it, and then I will select this face, and the angle is zero. Apply. Now let me check if it right view, may be view is proper. Even now the view is not proper, so now I will check which other plane is not coinciding. It should be the XY plane now then. So the XY plane is more or less proper. So there should be some XZ plane. Let us check the XZ plane. The YZ plane. Oh, we need to fix these planes. I hope you are getting why we are doing this, because there is a slight mismatch in the orientation. Now we will just set the angle between these two faces. So constraint, angle constraint, select this face, this plane, and between this face, we want the angle to be zero. I click on apply. I will first remove this grounded constraint command, and then let me constrain and then use the other options. Going to angle once again. Click on apply. Now let us check which other plane is not in orientation. There's an angle between the XZ plane also, so we will give a constraint in between them. Constraint, angle constraint between the XZ plane and the corresponding surface. Okay, now our figure is proper. Now this is the motion which is possible. So now we will constrain them to. Do you realize the mistake that's happening? Why it was not allowing us to constrain? If you look, there's a small mismatch in this component which I had. There's a small error with this component. So if you look closely, when I am rotating, it should be very clear to you. That is, see, the surface of this drag and release plate is digging into the surface of the release plate or the swivel plate. Here that is, here it is visible. So that is why it was not allowing us to constrain, because which means this locations of this hole is slightly offset. If that was drawn according to drawing, then you wouldn't have this problem and you could have made the necessary constraints and finished this case. It could be this holes, or it could be between the overall width that is required. This is 30 plus 18, which means the overall width is 48. This is 30. From this face is this 15. Let us check if it is meeting this criteria. We will open the swivel plate separately. Is this distance correct? If it has to be, this is in total 18. So if this is 15 from here, means the it should be 15 here. Now let us see if it's done. I click on OK. Now you see it has updated. Now it is not digging, it is locating. Now it is perfectly fine at this point. So Visual Style, shaded with edges. Slightly. Fine, you see the last constraint, assemble, constraint option, and from here, let us select the angle constraint. Clicking on the first part between this surface and this surface, the angle is to be zero, and I click on. So I will make this the front view. The right view. And this is the top. Let me save this file as the name to be given, clapper block assembly by default, so clapper block, and I click on save.